Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for joining me. I am Bhavna Sharma, and I will be presenting on structuring data management. Let's come to the outline of the presentation. I'm going to cover what is data management, structuring of data management, importance of data management, challenges, and finally the summary. Coming to the first slide of the presentation, what is data management? Data management is the process by which the required data is acquired, validated, stored, protected, and processed. It ensures the accessibility, reliability, and timeliness of procuring data. In the broader term, it is the organization of gathered information in such a way that the people looking for the specific information be able to find it and access it easily. And for the CSTEP, we are fortunate to have a data management process because it is very important to have an organization. How to structure a data? There are the following steps that involve the data management. They are assembling and planning data, collecting and checking data, assessing and documenting the data, selection repository to store data, storing and preserving data. So these are the few steps which help you to structure your data properly and with the in a good process. Assembling and planning data. The first and the initial step is to gather a data, which itself is a difficult task to gather a data, but later on the end user will be benefited out of it. The gathering data involves you talk to the researchers or the people face to face to gather the data, or you send out the query mail to them so that they can send you the desired data. The next point is plan for the data management as per the research requisite organization standards. This involves the same gathered data that you have initially collected. Plan for the data management as per the research necessary thing, keeping in mind the various users that are going to use your data that you have gathered at the end, and how will the data be organized within the file. That means if your organization, like for a CSTEP, we use a certain format, a file naming convention for our data. That will be easy for the end users to know how to store their data with the appropriate format or with the file name. How it will be accessed. That means the backup file, the backup folder that you keep for your data, where you can easily go and access the data collected. Develop a plan for sharing data with the project team and other collaborators. So you need to develop a plan, a proper process in which you're going to decide how you're going to share your data with your project team or with your collaborators or the funders. And for that, you need the various forms of folders and the way that you're going to put your data. Like for instance, for CSTEP, we capture the data domain-wise, and for the research work, we keep it as a project-wise so that researchers can easily go and access the data. And for the funders, we keep it by the funding name, and under that, though your funder name, the project list will be available with your desired database. Coming to the next slide, collecting and checking the data. Data should be collected to ensure its usability later. Methods and documentation should be considered carefully. For that, a template can be created for use during data collection. This will ensure the relevant contextual data are collected perform basic quality assurance and quality control on the data during data collection, entry, and analysis. Check the format of the data to maintain a consistency across the data set. For example, like the last slide I've mentioned, that for the CSEP, we use a file naming convention. For example, the CSEP underscore your file name underscore the date. So for that, you have to maintain a consistency throughout your documentation. Then identify the missing information. This means that if there are certain gaps that you don't have the the required data, so you may have to go back or search for it, or going through to your project list or the people who have worked on the certain project or that particular thing. So you have to fill the gaps that is there for your collection. Assessing and documenting data. Data documentation is the key to future use of data. It ensures the data be easily discovered, understood, or effectively used. For example, we keep a track of all the publications or all the written material that is from the CSEP. So we keep a track of all the database. So you have to document them properly for the end user, so that they can easily access your documentation easily and navigate the data properly with no without losing into the folders and files or asking or searching here and there. So you have to have your documentation properly with the proper name to have the end result good. Selecting a repository to store data. Identify the data repository that is most appropriate for the data you will generate and for the group of people that will make use of the data. For example, our CSEP DMS, that is the good example for our organization to have, because a lot of the organization may don't have a certain portal there where they are storing their or collecting their data. So we are fortunate to have this portal where we store all our CSEP documents. So for example, you can see there under the library, the CP folder, you can see the standards and guidelines and the templates. And further under template folder, you will find the template. So like this, all the data is maintained under DMS. So the end users can use it, and they have the access to these folders. There they have to directly go there and click on the desired folder, and the subfolders will appear, and as per their requirement, they can access their file. Storing and preserving data. As files are created, a data presentation plan is implemented that ensures that data can be recovered in the event of file loss. For example, storing the data routinely in different locations. For instance, the CSEP is again lucky to have the so many portals where your backup files are available. If you lost access to your particular folder, then you can make access to other different folders for the same file that you want. So CSEP has the pyramid, the DMS, the example I've told you about in the previous slide, your own personal folders, and the project management system. So there are four backup files that you have. So you can access to any of these for your files. So it's not that you have lost your one folder, so you can't access your data in the rest of the folders. So we are keeping a track on all these folders and maintaining it every day, routine basis, so that by end of the day, if you need any, you can use any of these folders and use your data. So the importance of the data management. this is the important slide, which people really don't feel the data management is important in their lives or in their research or in their organization. But it is a very important thing to have in your life. So it covers improved efficiency, protection from data-related risk, easy to navigate. Under improved efficiency, if the data is managed well, it will save a lot of time on corrective activity, which is true. I mean, if you are maintaining your data properly and you're keeping all the folders in the file with their proper names, so you can save a lot of time in figuring out or searching for your data in the folders and files or somewhere else. So it will improve the efficiency of your data. Backup and the recovery procedures and data handling procedures ensure that the data, a major asset for any research project, is never permanently lost. Likewise, in the previous slide, I told you they are going to, you have to have a backup on different portals where there's no chances of getting losing of your data. So you will have a backup of your for all the files that you have for the that you're going to use in your that you're going to use in the future. And by preserving the data in appropriate folders, ensures easy access. So if you're preserving the data properly in the desired folder in the particular folder, so you have good navigation to reach to your destination folders or the not the least the challenges of the data management. Time consuming. Yes, it is. Initially, when you start gathering your data and collecting your data, it takes a lot of time to make a complete list of your data that you want to collect. And for collection, you need to sit with the people to get the information, or you're going to search with the previous folders that are available to find out the data. So it will take a lot of time initially, but the end result is good. Involves regular follow-up. The data management involves a regular follow-up, which is necessary to have it, because if you are doing a certain project, so every day there is a new thing coming up for the project. There's a new information is there. So you need to update all your files accordingly and follow up with them every day or every week as per the project, as per the thing necessary. Establishing an organization level system for data management. Documenting the process of data management. Categorization of folders and files for easy navigation. So initially it is very difficult to how to store your data. If you have your files ready but you don't know how to store it, so that on that you have to decide how you're going to name your file or how going to name your folders, or that is a little difficult to decide on how to start with your collection and how are you to start your documenting all your process. So in my presentation, I have covered what is data management, structuring data management, importance of data management, challenges, and the stuff. Thank you.